Hello everyone, the Fair Gamer here, and welcome back to Let's Play Star Wars Jedi Outcast, and welcome to the next level. And yeah, right at the battle we have a bunch of guys, and there's a turret over there. But yeah, let's just take out these guys first. Ow. There we go. And let's take out the turrets. That's one down, and the other one is over here. There we go. So, yeah. We're supposed to get through that door, but the door is locked. And also, we got some new force powers, again. Like some upgraded ones, like Mind Trick. We can, like, confuse enemies for a little bit longer, and, we can, force grip enemies, and this time we can do damage to them. But what you are supposed to do is, you see this officer over here, and you notice that the crosshair is highlighted blue, so you have to use Mind Trick on this guy, and he will open the door for you. And just cut him up like that. See you a little bit first. There we go. Damn it! Die. Alright. Nice. Ooh, got him in half. Nice. No, they took a little bit of damage. They took a little bit of my health away, unfortunately, but oh well. But this game is this is not an easy game, especially on hard difficulty. So yeah, now we're over here and we have more of these workers. There we go. So, yeah. We are supposed to get through this door, but this door is locked. So, yeah, we can't go through there yet. So, yeah. You can get some ammo if you need, but what are we supposed to do? We need to, like, make this thing malfunction somehow. And the way of doing it is actually just jumping your way up there. Way up there. Well, if I can land the jump, I'm feeling a little bit at it. There we go. Oops. Didn't have enough speed. There we go. So, yeah. And just make a jump up here. And you can destroy these things, which you need to with anything you want, but yeah, they do damage to you, so be careful. Okay, let's destroy this last one, and then this thing malfunctions, and it blows up. And
not very subtle, but it seems to have gotten the job done.
Yep, and it blows open that door conveniently. So yeah, let's try to get safely down without taking damage. There we go. And there's some more guys up there. Oh, there's a Polygoroid. It's dead. There we go. Okay, some more stormtroopers. Let's see. Hello, worker. You die. That guy's kind of deadly if he lands a hit on you. Die. Oh, got his hand off. You can cut him apart a little bit more if you really want to. It's because, like I said a bunch of times, I have a realistic lightsaber thing on, which enables dismemberment a little bit more and make your saber do damage no matter what. Not your saber, but all lightsaber users. So yeah, let's head over here. Let's get some ammo. I don't need ammo, unfortunately. And take out these guys. Nice. You die. And I think I'm gonna encounter a reborn very soon. I think. Oh, that shotgun is kind of dangerous. Like, the most dangerous stormtroopers are the ones with the shotguns, because they deal so much damage when they hit you up close. And, yeah. And when you're using your lightsaber, obviously you are doing close combat most of the time. But if those guys hit you with the shotgun, like that thing over here, it basically almost instantly kills you if you are depending on it, on how much health you have. Oh, hello. And there's another turret over here. There we go. Force heal is so handy. You can get health after each encounter, which is really helpful. So you don't have to play super safe. Yeah, and this door just leads back to the area I was before with the thing that that malfunctioned. And yeah, oh, there's another turret over here. Nice. Oh, then you have this area. And this is a bit of a puzzle. And there's a stormtrooper with a shotgun firing those grenade things at me. Oh, I'm actually almost dead though. Let's get that stormtrooper. Where is he? There he is. There we go. Let's see, I need some help. I do have Bacta tanks also. Well, I had one. But Bacta tanks are getting a little bit more rare. Because you have Force Heal. Like, Force Heal kind of is replacing the Bacta tank on this game. Kill the dead guy doesn't kill me. But yeah, at this point you can't move while you're using Force Heal. And that guy is fabric firing on a stormtrooper rifle. Let's see. There you go, now he's dead. Okay, but yeah, as you can see, the floor is electrified, so yeah. If you walk on the floor, you die. So yeah, we need to platform our way a little bit around. Oh, careful! And there's another stormtrooper guy around this corner. Yeah, Force Heal is so slow. Okay. Let's wait until I get my force power back and just jump. Ooh, careful. Yeah, somewhere up there is another guy. There he is. So yeah, we need to. There's a couple of different ways you can do this. You can do it a little bit risky, or you can do it safe, but the safest way is to get in this tank first. And you can... Can you do it from up here? I don't think so, because this looks blocked off. Let's go around a little bit more. Yes, you can enter this thing from here. And just take this elevator up. And then you can go through this window. Go on this control room, grab any health or armor or whatever you want. And this switch make that platform move back a little bit for some reason, but this switch will disable the generator over there, so it's no longer electrified. Which means we can now safely walk our way on the floor without dying, of course. Okay, and then there is a doorway I'm supposed to take, I think. Yes, this doorway. And there are some human guys. And the guys have the shotgun. And those guys have repeater rifles. And there's another turret up there. Let's get rid of this turret. There we go. And let's get rid of these stormtroopers. Shit, there's a shotgun over there. Nice. Come on, die. But luckily you can block pretty much everything, so yeah. As long as you face the enemy up front, you're pretty much safe from enemy fire no matter what. Especially if your disabled defense got upgraded. Like, you still get hit a little bit sometimes, but not as much, not as often, luckily. And the guy is crying in pain, whatever. But yeah, we need to get through that door. And I think there's a switch we need to flip over here. Oh, and there are some trip mines. So yeah, let's get some detonators. Like this. Nice. And... yeah, shut up. And you can shoot these mines if you really want to. So, yeah. Okay, then let's move through here. Some armor, shield, whatever, and ammo if you need, and... aha, we got two reborns. So yeah, be careful of the lightsabers. Okay, that's one dead. Oh yeah, be careful of the slides here, but they kill you pretty fast. Ow. Yep. Oh, I think I got them both. Oh, nice. I think they can also do damage to each other if they dodged each other's lightsaber. I think, but I'm not sure. Okay, yeah, that's... I think... is there a secret? I know there is a secret in one of these things, but I don't think it's this one. Otherwise, yeah, this one is completely closed. Oh, there might be in a different level, but... oh yeah, this area. And yeah. And there's also a new weapon over here, which I can force pull towards me. And this is a destructive electric weapon which shoots like lightning bolts. Shortcut is the DEP weapon. And also, the reason I force pull that one is because there's also a new enemy over here, and this is like, yeah, an assault droid. But with this weapon, they die really quickly, actually, which is good. And they drop ammo, and they can drop ammo. And I think there's another one over here. Yes. And it's dead. Like, and that weapon is the most effective against those. And there's another reborn over there. So come on, come on. Oh, it was my lightsaber. Got him, nice. Oh, removed his head and his arm. That's nice. Okay. And let's head through this door. And yeah, this is a little... some areas are a little bit similar locking in this level. So yeah, and let's head up there. And up there there's a shitload of guys and a few turrets, I think. So yeah, let's just activate force speed. And kill everyone. Let's just take it easy a little bit. Nice. Like, the most dangerous ones are the turrets, of course. Nice. Okay, let's do this easy. Careful. Okay, that's that turret done, and let's take care of that other one. And pew 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 your way through here. And there we go. And do I have a supply key? Yes, I have, and that's a portable turret. Which you can deploy. So you can use them against your own defense. And there's some vector tanks over here. There we go. Okay, let's head through this door. Another switch I need to flip over here, so... Another guy also has a key. Ow, 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 ow. I want you all dead. Die. There we go. And one of them has a key. Another guy has no hands anymore. And now he has barely any arms. So yeah, flip this switch.
Like some kind of assault ships. And they seem to be packing them for a little trip.
Yes, activating the switch will move one of those bolts around. And I think this is the one that has a secret in them. Inside of it. I think. But I'm not sure. Maybe I'm thinking of a different level then, but I know it is a secret in one of those things in this game. Like extra items and stuff. And up here, we have another reborn. Careful, careful. Got him! Nice. Got him in half. That's nice. There we go. Full health. Always handy. Like, Force Heal make this game actually a little bit easier. Because you can pretty much heal after every encounter, which is really good. And you can heal at a pretty decent rate because your Force Power regenerates pretty fast, actually. No, that was a hit. And he has no head anymore. Nice. Let's see, ammo? I don't need ammo. And over here there are more reborn. Let's face them. Oh, that was a saber lock. Pretty much, if you're in that state of combat with the saber at any time, just button mash your mouse button. And the faster you press your mouse, the quicker you can get out of it. And if you don't succeed, you kind of they can like go for a cannon blow. Yeah, I need to really play like a little bit safe, sorry, because the sabers are also extremely deadly, and there's an AT-ST. But you can just ignore this thing, or you can get crushed by them. Okay, that's one of them dead, and that's my head cut off. Like, saber throw works extremely well with this saber combat thing enabled. So yeah, let's don't get crushed again by that AT-ST. And let's just head over here. That thing will not follow you, by the way, in here. Oh, I guess it does. And I got crushed again. Ow. Ow. Okay, let's move back a little bit and heal up a little bit. Let's just save this game this time so I don't have to deal with these reborn again every time I die. I can also try to get it though with this thing. As long as you don't get crushed by this thing. Ow. Looks like it can't hit me. Oh, it can. Whatever. I didn't say anything. Bye bye. And that was a rocket. Just screw that AT-ST. I'm just going to run past it. And don't get crushed by him. There we go. There's a bunch of guys over here. And that AT-ST killed me again. You don't really have that much weapons against it that is really effective. So, yeah. But the annoying thing is, this thing follows you inside that room. Maybe if I force speeds, so it can keep up with me. And hopefully, when these doors are closed, this thing will not follow me. Well, and it followed me in here anyway. Well, just ignore this. I'm just gonna ignore these guys and just jump straight into here. Huh. You can also ignore those guys and just go straight in. Yeah, and there's some trip mines over here. So let's get that thermal detonator then and throw a one around the corner. There we go. Careful. Let's clear out these mines nice and easy. Let's use the bio pistol. It's a little bit more accurate. Yeah, the AT-ST is just chilling up there, but I don't care. Ah, shield dispenser, nice. Let's just heal up a little bit. Okay, I need 20 heal hit points more. Oh, hello. Oh, luckily they can. Luckily they can't come in here. And yeah, jump into this hole to enter the level. Nice. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed this video and I see you in the next one. But yeah, until then, take care and bye bye.